solution. And the invitation about it's written. It's handwritten. It's not even emailed. It's handwritten with love. And the invitation is to see if you can allow yourself to become the observer. And as we allow ourselves to become the observer, inevitably, we also realize that we are both the observer and the one being observed. So you'll fluctuate between those two roles. But I invite you to just keep that in mind as we move on that. As you're ready, bring your hands to the heart. Gently bow the head. Mind intelligence. To the body intelligence. Sweet. Inhale in. Exhale, slowly release. Open the eyes. Fingertips come to the earth. What's up, observer? Here we go. Inhale, halfway lift. Fingertips out, left right. With your breath, sink it up. Exhale, palms come together. Now you might practice today retaining your breath here as you reach behind, bring the palms together, chin to chest, and then inhale, reach for the sky all the way up. Exhale, float it down, wiggle the fingertips. Twice more. Inhale, fingertips left to right. With the sound of your breath, exhale, reel it in. Maybe pause, retain the breath as you drop chin to chest. Can't really talk and retain my breath. Bring the hands behind. Good, and then inhale, reach all the way up to the sky. Exhale, float it down. Once more, just with a breath. Here we go. Chin to chest, reach behind. And exhale to release. A little bit of a change today. Inhale, reach the right arm up. Exhale, right arm to left knee, left fingertips swim behind. Gentle twist here. Inhale to lift the chest. Excuse me. Exhale to gently look over your left shoulder. Imagine someone's kissing you softly on your neck here on the right side. And then all the way back to center, you melt. And then we'll inhale, reach the left arm up high, big stretch. Exhale, left palm to the right knee. Right fingertips swim behind. And I say swim because we're integrating, right? Each moment, connecting the dots. And then inhale to lift the chest. Exhale, gentle twist to your right. See what happens if you look past your right shoulder, but don't crank. That's why I love the image of getting a little kiss, a soft kiss on your back. And don't you worry about who's kissing you. It could just be an arrangement, just a little kiss, reminding you that you're worthy of love. All right, bring it back to center. Let's take it all the way through onto all fours, tabletop position. Move lightly. Pay attention. How you move matters. From your tabletop position, right into cat-cow. Inhale, drop the belly, open the chest. With your breath, exhale, round through, chin to the chest. Find that bottom breath here. Inhale, drop the belly, open the arms. Exhale, round through, claw through the fingertips, chin to chest. Now a couple of rounds on your own. Recognizing, noticing how you feel. Establishing that connection, that relationship to your foundation, physically, so alignment-based, but also energetically. Awesome, and then start to bump the hips left to right. Find what feels good today, checking in with your body, again, physically, but also just noticing your energy level. And then take this little dance, whatever it is you've cultivated here, and make your way to downward dog in your own time.
checking in here with your foundation. Same thing, recognizing how this feels. And then bend the knees generously. Inhale, look forward. And exhale, step, hop, two-step. Grapevine, any which way you like, all the way to the top. So really make it your own. And then we'll meet in a forward fold. Feet hip-width apart or flush together today. Just nice, conscious footing. So taking stock, but really noticing your pattern. So if you tend to practice with the feet together, maybe today you take them hip-width apart. And now back to the breath. Lifting the breath. And then allowing a big inhale to lift you up halfway, your version, just to find some length in the spine and the neck. Remember, the neck is an extension of the spine. And then use an exhale to fold. And then take your time. Take your time as you slowly roll up the mountain. Enjoy this move. Take your time. Slowly. Stacking up through the spine, grounding to the feet, mountain pose. Now here today, I invite you to take the knee, feeling up, but just ask yourself, do I need that? Do I need that? And if you do, this is your practice, particularly your home practice, you know, do what you like. But just be aware, observe, like, am I kind of going into some nerves? Not saying you are, just something that you can continue to look at throughout our journey. And there's no shame. Like, if you got to, you know, fix your pantaloons, you know, your hair, that's fine. But just keep asking yourself, do I really need that? Each time you come to Tadasana, mountain pose, it's a great opportunity to check in with those moments, just kind of like your patterns, your the moments in between, right? The space in between. Because the space in between is where the magic. I love Yo-Yo Ma talks about the moment between the notes. So hopefully you're here, and if you did do a lot of stuff, awesome, power to you. It's just about awareness. It's my job to just keep asking questions and inviting you to go a little deeper. So at the very least, though, we're grounding through the feet. We're drawing in towards center a little bit by drawing the navel in and out. And then I'd like for you to consider this lift of energy through the front body. And then it's kind of like a loop. It goes down the back body. And again, this is a lot of what Hatha Yoga is all about. Sun, energy, immunity, coming together, masculine, feminine, right part, up, down. What goes up must go down after we expand. After that contracts. So it's a really nice way to balance out your energetic body. But if that's not something that resonates for you. I mean, this is stuff that we learn in strength training too. We're learning to create a brace for the body so it can work in the best capacity, in the most functional way. So that's a lot to chew on here. But I want to kind of start to introduce these things so that once we start to build vocabulary, you already have one. Okay. Let's draw the hands to the heart. Take a deep breath in and lift the sternum to the thumbs. And just play with that. Lifting up through the front body. Some of you have heard me say this a million times, but I'm going to do it anyway. You can kind of give yourself the image of like Kate when you're like the front of the bow. Just like my heart will go on. Your heart's lifting, lifting, lifting. Your energetic body is just at the top, sitting beyond, sitting at the top of the body. And then in the back body, we balance that out by rounding wherever we can. Shoulder blades. Hug in and slide down the back body. You might tag a little weight in your elbows down. You dig into the heels. And now, a big... come through the room, and you will be centered. You balance the up and down. You have that connection when you're working. Here. your exhale to relax the shoulders. Big beach ball. Exhale. You're going to bend your knees. Right fingertips are going to go forward. Left fingertips are going to go back. Open twist to the left. Okay? Keep the loop of energy up and down in the front of the body. Here we go. Inhale. Reach it back up through center. Exhale. Bend your knees. Big open twist to the right. Right fingertips back. Left fingertips forward. Breathe. Awesome. Come back to center. Inhale to reach it up. Wiggle the fingertips as you bend the knees and bring it down. Inhale, halfway lift. Find the length in the neck. Reach through the crown. And exhale to soften everything and fold open. Awesome work. You're going to bend the knees, plant the palms here. Step the right toes back, step the left toes back. I'm going to give you a break on the planks today, so come all the way to them. Awesome. Press into the tops of the feet. Squeeze the elbows into the side body. Inhale. Tuck the chin, unfurl or uncurl as you inhale, breathing cobra. Exhale, forehead kisses the butt.
Twice more, inhale,
rolling up slowly. Exhale to release. On the third one, listen carefully, press into your foundation. Inhale, roll up. And when you feel like you've hit a nice place where you're not muscling through the arms, you're going to lift the palms all the way up. Strengthening the back body mindfully. You shouldn't be clenching or holding or in pain here. If you are, just come back a little bit. Awesome. Inhale. Lift your figurative heart space up between your shoulder blades. Just a little rise and catch a and fall. Okay. Or into the back. Great work. Curl the toes under. Lift the kneecaps. Tone the quads. Here we go. Inhale in. Big transition. Exhale. Press up to plank or all fours. Inhale in again. Exhale, downward facing. Awesome. Pedal it out here. Find a little more depth of breath, whatever that means to you. Spiraling back to your heart song. Listening to your breath is a practice of listening to the wisdom of the heart, right? Instead of the brain. So if that's not motivation to breathe and listen to your breath, I love that. It's like we talked about in discernment. Like we're recognizing why. We're not just breathing deep in yoga because that's what you do in yoga, but why? What's the connection? And from that little conversation comes up into the yoga. And look, okay, ground through the left heel. Here we go. Inhale, lift the right leg up high. Dial the right toes down. You got this. Bathing pulses. Right heel, just bathing pulses up towards the sky. Walk through the fingertips. If this is too much for your body, gently come down onto your left knee and do it here. Now coming back to the role of the observer. What's going on in your face? What's going on with your breath? Moving to shoulder stability by drawing the upper arm bones out. Biceps towards the feet. Baby pulses for 3, 2, one awesome way to get strong, squeeze the right knee all the way up and in and then walk those wrists by bringing the right foot forward, pivoting on the back foot, front knee over front ankle, so front knee bent, and we're going to roll it up. And as you roll up, keep the left inner thigh engaged. So much energy and power when you really connect to that joint that we have. Hands can come to the waistline if you're feeling a little off balance today. Otherwise, take the arms all the way up. Big breath in, inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Widen your stance if you need to. Find that loop of energy. Lifting up through the front body, grounding through the back body. Here we go. Inhale in. This time, exhale, we're going to bend the right elbow. Slowly bring it to the top of the right thigh. Then take your left hand to your right rib cage, and you're going to imagine you're smearing some honey or some delicious substance. Ayo, first Ayo of the series. Okay. Go smooth, your delicious substance. Then there's the issue of bees. Okay. But let's smooth something all across the belly. Hopefully this will help you remember this spiral. All the way. all the way up. So heart's working to spiral up towards the sky without collapsing in the right shoulder, right neck line. So keep it nice and long. Charge, engage your left inner thigh, and then find that loop. Extended side angle, so wonderful for connecting with Danda, creating a healthy flow of energy that runs up and down the spine, strengthening the glutes while opening the hips. You can stay here or inhale, send your left fingertips to the sky. If you want a little more, do more too. You want to try sending your right fingertips all the way down to the breathe into them. Strong legs. Open the heart. One breath. Big inhale. Exhale. Take your left fingertips down past through your heart space. All the way through. We're going to pivot on the back foot. We're going to open up the right foot just a bit. So take a nice wide stance. Breathe into the belly, reach back with your left heel. One more breath, wiggle the right fingertips. Exhale, bring it all the way down. Plant the palms, step the right toes back, plank or half plank. Let's get out of here, I promise. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, slowly over to the left. Inhale, baby cobra. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, soften it up.
Curl the toes under, lift the kneecaps. Here we go. Inhale. Exhale. Press up to half plank.
Inhale and again. Exhale. Downward dog.
Observe your breath. Spread the fingers wide. Anchor through the right heel. Here we go with the breath. Inhale with the left leg up high. Three-legged dog.
So hugging, connecting to that foundation, hugging to the midline. So we're not collapsing in the right side of the body. We're clawing through the fingertips to take pressure out of the wrist.
Then dial the left toes down, breathe and pulse if you've got this. Building in moments of challenge so that you can practice. How do I treat myself? How do I react in the moments? Present. And I reside in the role of the observer. You're doing great. You're here for 2, 1. Here we go. Nice work. Squeeze the left knee all the way up and in. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And then step it all the way up. Nice low lunge.
We'll come off the wrist. Here we go. Pivoting on the back foot, front knee over front ankle. So you have it, particularly if you've been practicing for a long time. You have an opportunity here to create the strongest base for warriors that ever existed, no, but that maybe you've ever done before by rolling up. So you can really ground through the feet. You can imagine drawing your feet into center as you keep that front knee over the front ankle, also building stability on the knee this way, and roll up through the spine. Yeah. Hands come to the waistline if you need, if you'd like. Now, as you bring the fingertips up, you have to claw through the outer edge of that back foot. Everything working together as one, negotiating. Beautiful. Inhale in. Maybe you're looking up. And then exhale, warrior two, opening up. Find that loop of energy. Staying with your breath. Head over heart, heart over heart. So mindful, so beautiful, so caring. Take one more breath. Exhale, bend your left elbow. Bring it to the top of the left thigh. Left hip crease pulls back just a bit as you claw through the outer edge of your back foot so you can create some space here. And then take the right hand to your left rib and smear. Find something to smooth across your rib cage. You're going to get in trouble for this one, but smear some beautiful honey and opening your adjustments. So this is big, and if you're new to the practice, you're not going to get very far, so be patient, be kind, and that's why this power of touch goes a long way, this kind of opening. Keep the right inner thigh engaged, super important.
Tailbone reaching down, down, down. Heart lifting up. Then I'm not collapsing the neck here or the shoulder, so I can take my right fingertips up towards the sky. Take your time. Beautiful, beautiful. Remember, creating a 100% full body experience, not moving parts, working one body part at a time, but working with the body as one. If you want, taking the left fingertips all the way down. Just go challenge your breath so you can breathe down this way. Slowly lift and turn. And then inhaling again. Use your exhale and take your right hand through, close to your heart space. Bring it all the way down to the ground with care. You're going to pivot on your back foot, walk the left foot out just a bit, give yourself a wider base. Then right hand to the earth, and here we go. We will be back in and lift your knee. Bring it into your belly. Imagine there's a little bell up there. You know, reach, 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 and try to ring the bell with your fingers. Wiggle your fingertips, inhale, and then exhale. Inhale, way back down. Also, want to plant the palms, step it back. You're going to go straight to downward dog here and just pedal it up. Deep breath in through the nose, long breath out through the nose or mouth. One more, just like that. Big inhale in through the nostrils, and then long exhale to let something go. Awesome. From here, you're going to step to the center of your mat, just the center of your mat. Feet hip width apart or flush together. Doesn't matter to me. Just nice, conscious footing. Toes pointing forward. As you're ready, inhale. Let's take it up halfway. Nice flat back position, long neck. And then exhale to soften and release. Root to rise here. Send the fingertips forward as you inhale. Reach up and back. Maybe slight back bend here as you lift your heart to the sky. And then exhale, hands to heart, mountain pose. Take what you need here, leave what you don't. Close your eyes, observe your breath. And gently open your eyes, keep your chin lifted. And without looking down, okay? So you know, you take your eyeballs, you put them on the soles of your feet, right? And you're just going to pop them down there, and you can look at the video if you like. Try not to look down, you're going to put your eyeballs on the soles of your feet. As Mr. Shakespeare once wrote, see feelingly. You don't need to look down. Draw the feet together. You don't need to look down. If you did look down, no worries. The learning experience. It's beautiful. Isn't it so cool that we're all participating in this beautiful learning experience where in the end the benefits are we just get stronger, leaner, more flexible, have more energy. Like it's just, it's a win-win. So remember that. Not here to do the yoga. We're here to have an experience. So feet are together. We'll shift the weight to the left foot. Again, try not to look down. Your foot knows what to do. Left foot grounds. Slowly, we're going to lift the right heel up. Maybe right knee up, just standing one leg in Tadasana. But that's up to you. Maybe we're a little tight here. Maybe our balance is off today. So we might just keep a big toe on the ground. Okay, if you're in a standing one leg in Tadasana, you might lift the chest, find that loop of energy, take your right foot and bring it in towards the end seam of your leg. Maybe heel comes all the way up towards the base of the spine. Or maybe below the knee, or if you're on the big toe, you can just open the hip here and keep the big toe on the ground. Okay, so we're coming into your version of Vrksasana today, our last shape where we get to practice being in the role of the observer on the mat today. So find that loop of energy wherever you are. Stand up nice and tall, so instead of collapsing into your standing leg, you're lifting up out of it. Quiet down for a second and allow you to just listen to the sound of your breath. Find a focus out in front. If you need a challenge today, send your focus all the way up towards the sky. And you can be in your moment. Close your eyes.
do you take it into a variation?
And when you're ready, follow your breath, whatever that means to you, all the way back. Inhaling deeply when you land, and exhale completely. Now try not to look down, but if the feet have come apart, bring them together. And do the same thing on the other side. You're doing awesome. Stick with it. Nice, smooth breaths. Lifting left heel up. You might stay here. And taking everything we've learned thus far and putting it into this movement. Putting it into that right part. How do you make it in? Maybe you take it to a standing legged pranayama. And maybe you find a version of tree that you've never done before on this side. Maybe heel all the way up, maybe on the calf, maybe big toes on the ground. And the same thing, I'm going to quiet down so you can really allow your sound track to be the sound of your breath. Here to take a variation on the bottom. Following your breath to take it all the way down. And if you fall, we'll catch you. Falling is part of the game. So like learn to fall gracefully in yoga and learn to love ourselves through the fall instead of feeling ashamed or embarrassment. Meet in mountain pose, palms together. So stand up nice and tall here, take one last breath in. And as you exhale, relax the shoulders down and bow your head to your heart. Before we sign off today, take one final quiet moment to observe the breath. Inhale in. And exhale out, you're done. Awesome work. We quietly whisper. Namaste. Thank you.